Surah Al-Bayna, chapter number 98 in the Holy Quran, out of 114 chapters. Surah Al-Bayna, it is Madani Surah. It's 8 verses, and let's see what the main message of this surah. The people of the book did not get divided into sects until they received guidance. And they were also commanded to establish prayer and to give charity. When we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must be sincere. These are the main messages of the surah. The abad of the people of the book and the infidels. The ultimate abad for the believers in paradise for eternity. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. These verses here, number one, the title number one, the virtue of, or the superiority of the Quran and the mission of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين منفكين حتى تأتيهم البينة. Those who reject the truth among the followers of the scripture, Jewish and the Christians, and the polytheists, the المشركين, the infidels, those who used to worship the idols, كفار مكة, and anybody in Arabia used to do like them, worshiping statues. They were not going to depart their disbelief until there had come to them clear evidence. Rasulun min Allah yatlu suhufan mutahhara. A messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from Allah. From Allah means Allah, the one who sent him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a Nabi for all mankind. Reciting verses, yatlu suhufan, of the Quran that are purified from the falsehood. The Quran, Al-Kareem also can call it suhuf. Yes, suhuf. صحف المطهرة means the Holy Quran too. فيها كتب قيمة. In these verses, the verses of the Holy Quran, true news and decrees that are right and just leading to straight path. طيب, what we learn from the Quran, this is the benefits of the ayat of the Quran al-Kareem. The verses of the Quran, it's true. There is nothing fake in the Holy Quran, subhanAllah. And also, يعني, it leads people to the right path. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا تَفَرَّقَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَتْهُمُ الْبَيِّنَةِ. And the people of the scriptures did not divide it until the promised sign came to them clear, as it was promised in their scripture. And they agreed that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that sign. It means Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his name was written in the book of the Torah. Torah and they give, and they also the Bible, they give glad tidings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ومبشرا برسول يأتي من بعدي اسمه أحمد عيسى عليه السلام. They give glad tidings of Rasulullah's coming. فالله سبحانه وتعالى saying, وما تفرق الذين أوتوا الكتاب إلا من بعد ما جاءتهم البينة. Yes, but in what is البينة? That Rasulullah being mentioned in their book. They've been divided. But after that, they divided and denied him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and belied what was revealed to him. They belied the Quran. وَمَا أُمِرُوا. That's a great verse in the surah. Number 5. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلَصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ حُنَفَاءَ وَيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ. Is that only for the people of scripture? No, it's for them and for us too. As I said all the time, one of the rules of the Quran, Al-Quran بِعْمُومِ اللَّفْظُ وَلَيْسَ بِخُصُوصِ السَّبَبِ, means if Allah command Bani Israel for something, this command and order for us too. It is not just only for them. For he said, and they were commanded to worship Allah. Just only Bani Israel or people of scripture? No, that we've been commanded to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهِ. And they were commanded to worship Allah and none but him. Straightforward, perform prayers, give charities, and that is the religion, right? And straight deenul qayyimah. I have a title here. The threat of Allah to the disbelievers. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ شَرُّ الْبَرِيَّةِ. سبحان الله. Indeed, those who disbelieve in Islam, the Quran, and Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, from among the people of the scripture, see, مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ, the word mean not all of them, from among them, يعني, not all of them, they disbelieve in Rasulullah or the Quran or the Islam. Min هنا بيسموها in Arabic language, min التبعيد. التبعيد يعني إيه? Some of them, not all of them. Min أهل الكتاب. From among them, not all of them. Yeah. And Allah said in Surah Al-Imran, ليسوا سواء. ليس سوى منهم أمة قائمة. Yeah, some of them they are good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, these people from among the people of scripture and those who associate gods beside Allah shall be abide in the hellfire, and they are the worst of all creatures. Who is the worst in all creatures? Sharrul bariyya, those who are denying the Quran and Islam, Muhammad, and they set partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And nothing worse than that. Nothing bad like shirk. And Allah can forgive all of your sin except this one. That sin. Shirk. What kind of khati'a will lead people to the hell for eternity? Shirk. It's one sin. Just only one sin. Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah. Aywa, subhanAllah. وَأَحَاطَتْ بِهِ خَطِيئَة. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as usual, is talking about the people of Iman, the glad tidings of paradise to the believers. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا, the opposite now. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أُولَئِكَ هُمْ خَيْرُ الْبَرِيَّةِ جَزَاؤُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ خَشِيَ رَبَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about those who believe. On other side, on other hand, those who believed in the oneness of Allah, the core of the message of Islam, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, Tawheed. This is the best, nothing better than that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have created the heaven, the earth, the Jannah, the hellfire, and they send the prophets, messengers, all for what? To convey and to tell people, say La ilaha illallah tuflih. La ilaha illallah. فقال لك لا إله إلا الله هو القطب ده الذي يدور عليه رحل الإسلام. Everything around the Islam, they all going around the one pillar. What is the pillar? لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. If لا إله إلا محمد رسول الله exists, that's it. If it is not there, there is a big problem. And Allah has sent all of these messages, أنبياء, جنة, نار, make all of that just for لا إله إلا الله. On other hand, those who believed in the oneness of Allah and in his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also وعملوا الصالحات and did good deeds, righteous good deeds, they are the best of the creations. خير البرية. Those who sit partner with Allah, شر البرية, the worst. Who the best of the البرية, creatures, those who believe in the oneness of Allah. Their reward with their Lord, Allah, will be gardens of paradise. Paradise what? جنات عدن إيدين. Beneath which rivers? And I explained that before. Hina said, تجري من تحتها. تجري من تحتها means the source of the water comes from under the Jannah itself. Sometimes Allah said in the Quran, تجري تحتها الأنهار. تجري تحتها means the source is coming from far away. But here, he said that جنات عدن, its water comes from underneath. It is not from far away. And he said, beneath which rivers, and they dwell therein forever, because Allah is well pleased with them, and they are with him. That is for him who feared his Lord and was obedient to him in this earthly life. So, Surah Al-Bayna, it's a Madani Surah. One time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is telling us that story. One time Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he went with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the house of Ubay ibn Ka'ab. Who's Ubay ibn Ka'ab? He was a Jewish guy. And he became Muslim, not just Muslim. He was memorizing the whole entire Quran. Not just that. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him a title among the Sahaba. Khal, Ya Abal Munzir, his nickname was Abal Munzir. He said, Anta Sayyidul Qurra, you are the master of the Qari of the Holy Quran. He was the master from amongst the Sahaba. He's the original. Yani, subhanAllah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, I went with Rasulullah to his house, to the house of Ubay ibn Ka'ab. And we knocked the door. Ubay said, who is this? I said, I am Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam. And they said, I was thinking about all Muhammads except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's a big honor, you know, Rasulullah to come to my house. He opened the door and he said, welcome here, Rasulullah. Why did not call me? I will come to you. He said, no, I get order from Allah to come to you. What? He said, yes. I came to you by Allah's order. And Allah, Azza wa Jal, command me or give me order to come to you and to recite Surah Al-Bayna. This is the chapter. This chapter upon you. Who gonna recite? Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam will recite and Ubay will listen. This chapter, Surah Al-Bayna. And Ubay started looking at Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was there. He was a qari of Quran too, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Ubay was looking at Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, did Allah mention my name to you? He said, yes. Ya Rasulullah, again, did Allah mention my name to you? He said, yes. He said, you are very famous there in the heaven. All the malaika and everybody knows you.
And he start, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, فَجَعَلَ أُبَيٌّ يَبْكِي. And I look at the eyes of Ubay, I see him crying and tearing. It's a big honor, you know. Rasulullah has come to somebody. Not just that, Rasulullah is reciting and Ubay is listening to the recitation of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? The scholar said when they explained that hadith, he said, because this surah talks about the people of the book, about the people of the scriptures. And Ubay ibn Ka'b, he was a Jewish, was a Jew. And subhanAllah, this ayah is talking about him. How? And Taban, of course, he was a big Qari and a big master of the Qur'an. Rasulullah, when he used to ask about any question about Qur'an, nobody did not answer. Nobody answered him except Ubay ibn Ka'b. One time he said, that verse, it's the greatest verse in the whole Qur'an. And Rasulullah was asking the question. Nobody answered. And Ubay ibn Ka'b said, Ya Rasulullah, I know the answer. What's that? He said, Ayat al-Kursi. And Rasulullah was wiping his chest with his hand. He said, لِيَهْنَكَ الْعِلْمُ أَبَى الْمُنْذِرِ. Congratulations for your knowledge, man. You have knowledge. Because just he answered him, what is the greatest verse in the Holy Quran? He said, Ayat al-Kursi. See, فَإِحْنَا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ we are great. We know Ayat al-Kursi is the greatest verse in the Holy Quran. We know Allah, alhamdulillah. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabb, to accept it from us, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Asking Allah Azza wa Jal to guide all our hearts to Him. To believe in His oneness, Ameen, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. وَمَنْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ Ya Rabb al-Alameen, نَحْنُ نُؤْمِنُ بِكَ Ya Rabb, وَنَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَيْكَ Ya Rahman Rahimeen. Ya Rabb, استُرْنَا وَاجْبُرْنَا وَعَفِنَا وَاهْدِنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا وَاغْفِرْ لَنَا وَاجْعَلْهُ فِي مِيزَانِ حَسَنَتِنَا وَارْفَعْ دَرَجَاتِنَا Ya Rabb. اللهم انفعنا بالقرآن وانفعنا بالقرآن وارفعنا بالقرآن واجعله حجة لنا لا علينا يا رب العالمين. نسألك خير هذا اليوم وخير ما فيه وخير ما بعده. أعوذ بك من شره ومن شر ما فيه ومن شر ما بعده يا رب العالمين. اغفر لآبائنا ولأمتنا كما ربينا صغيرا يا رب العالمين. واهدي أولادنا يا رب العالمين وثبتهم على الإيمان والإسلام يا أرحم الراحمين. وعافينا في أسماعنا وأبصارنا وأبداننا ما أحييتنا واجعل الوارث منا. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا.